There's a big win for new families tonight with bolstered paid parental leave laws passing the Senate. Let's go live now to our political editor, Charles Croucher in Canberra. Charles, good evening. What's the new arrangement?
Evening, Pete. Well, the government's current 20-week paid parental leave scheme will move to a 22-week scheme from July this year. It will grow again to 24-week scheme next year and 26 weeks from July of 2026. The new rules stipulate at least 4 weeks must be taken by each parent, and the parents can take a month simultaneously. This long-flagged reform is tonight finally through the Parliament ahead of the addition of superannuation to paid parental leave that will come in the budget in May. The victory, a welcome win for Labor as an old problem plagues the government. Starting the week on social media, the Prime Minister posting ministers heading into cabinet to the beats of a Fred Again song featuring the line, "This year we've had to lose." And at the High Court, they may be about to lose again.
What are they up to? It is just a mess which keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
Next month, the High Court is scheduled to hear a case of an Iranian man known as AS-17. The federal court has already ruled he should be deported, but he's not cooperating with officials. Now, if this challenge is successful, it could lead to the release of more detainees in similar situations.
The government believes that these individuals, those who are not cooperating with their removal, should be removed from Australia as a priority, and if they, while they are not, they should remain in immigration detention.
It seems like they were preparing the ground to release a further 100 to 150 hardened criminals.
The government will argue against the release. Jackie Lambie tonight arguing against the minister.
Yes, he should go. I'm sick and tired of watching ministers that sit there, that bugger up, and there is no repercussions for them.
How many more hardcore criminals are you going to release?
They are playing politics as we get on with the job of fixing up the mess.
The saga began here at the High Court. Now, with a myriad of legal cases ahead, the government will attempt to legislate a solution, but even that will likely face a challenge back here. Charles Croucher, Nine News.